Gutters.
Έχετε 4 γράμματα, λέει.
Ευχαριστώ.
Παρακαλώ.
Tell me about Alan Haldane.
What do you want to know?
Everything. And who else can I ask? He's your friend.
More than that, my brother. I owe him my life.
So tell me about him.
He was here during the war in Crete with the Andartes, with my group. He was my right hand. We call him Leandros. And then in 1944, when the island was liberated, he was sent back to England.
Go on.
I know little about his life after that time, except that he built boats, he married, and that 6 years ago his wife was killed in an accident.
All this I already knew.
Yes, of course, he will have told you himself.
You know then that I have been seeing him since he returned?
Often, I believe.
From time to time.
So, what can I tell you about him that you don't already know?
Of the man that he is, as you see him.
He's brave, honest, a man who has made his share of mistakes and who has suffered for them.
And what is it that he is afraid of? Can you tell me that?
Afraid of? Little, I think.
He's afraid of me, of what I offer, of what he knows I'm offering, freely and without reserve or even conditions. Do I shock you?
No. Because I know you. And because I admire your independence. And because also I know that love is a gift that you would not give lightly. Perhaps he doesn't want to hurt you.
But for him it's the same way, Babis. He needs me as I need him. He cannot hide that. I see it in his eyes.
Of harming you in some way, then?
You know, don't you? You know what it is he fears.
I know this. Leandros is a man that I would trust with my life. You would trust him with your happiness. Place it in his hands. That is a terrible responsibility. And one which he may feel that he cannot accept.
Because I'm wrong? Because I have read in his eyes only what I wanted to read?
No. Because you are right.
Θέλω να το πουλήσω, το καταλαβαίνει.
Τα είπαμε.
Βρε, έχω ανάγκη τα λεφτά να το καταλάβει. Το πάρει να πάρει.
Άσε την ευχή, παράτα με
πια. Θα το πουλήσω, καταλαβαίνει. Θες, δεν θες.
Πούλα το, δεν το πουλάω εγώ.
Δεν θέλω, εγώ
ας την ευχή πια, ας την ευχή.
Νίκο. Ελένα.
Καλημέρα, Ελένα.
Καλημέρα. You are not working on the boat today.
No, I did this morning. I'm going into Heraklion now to see a Babi Spiridakis. He says he's found a car for me. It's a bargain. It was impounded by the customs or something. Non-payment of duty. Anyway, he thinks I can get it cheaply.
You want a coffee?
Mm, all right.
Κύριε Χαλντέι.
Well,
you did this.
Mm-hmm.
You are a very clever man, Leandros.
Oh, I don't know about that. It's just a drawing, you know, it's an impression. We'd have to have an architect to make the proper plans, but what do you think of the idea?
Oh, I think it is a very good one. As you said before, more money, but without many changes. I would like that.
And Nikos?
Oh, who can say? For me, I think that Nikos would need much convincing.
Well, what if we had Babis Spiridakis on our side, what then?
Yes, perhaps, but even more so if it was my aunt Anika that would speak in favor of the plan.
Anika?
Nikos admires her. He would never say so, because for a woman in Crete, she's, how do you say it?
Different, I suppose, unconventional.
She is different, but she has made a big success in her own business, and when she speaks only the truth. Nikos knows this, and when she talks, he listens.
All right, I'll talk to Anika first.
That would please her, I think. She welcomes seeing you. You know that.
Yeah, well, if I'm going to get that bus to Heraklion, I'd better get going. Well, I'll let you know what your aunt says, and, well, if she likes the idea, the best thing we can do is all sit down and have a talk.
Why, Leandros?
Why what?
The drawing. The calculations. Everything. Why did you bring your plan here to us?
Well, perhaps because I know, well, I think I know how you feel. You see, I once had something I built from nothing, something I loved very much, and that was taken away from me by money. Or maybe because it's just a very good idea and there's a profit in it. For everyone. I'll see you.
Must for your cake. It is a gift for Kyria Zeferis. She found it in a boatyard in Heraklion. It's old.
Well, that's marvelous. It's exactly what I wanted, but well, a gift. Well, she shouldn't have done that.
No.
You going back to Heraklion?
Yes.
Good. You can give me a lift. Calispera.
Calispera, how are you?
I'm very well. Today has been a very good day for me so far.
I'm glad.
I've bought a car and someone has given me a mast.
You like it? Is what you needed?
It's exactly what I needed, but I really can't
let you... The joy in what is given is in how it is received. Would you rob me of happiness, Leandros?
No. Not if I could prevent it.
You can, this moment. Accept my gift.
It's a handsome present.
Things are easy to give. They show only that you're in someone's mind. Oh, it's beautiful.
There's no comparison.
A gift is not a debt. Neither is it something to be weighed or measured.
I would have brought those, mast or no mast.
Because?
Because you're in my mind, and to please you and to please myself.
In that case, thank you. I put them in water. So now you have a car.
Yes.
I'm glad. Because now you have no excuse for not visiting me.
Oh, you think I find excuses still?
Haven't you?
No. You're a very busy woman. You've got a factory to run. And I've been working very hard on my Kaiki.
It goes well?
Mm-hmm. Slowly, but well.
Oh, good. Only today you have forsaken it, for me?
Yes, to see you. To thank you. And because I need your help.
I see. Well, that's something at least. It has to be a good thing that you come to me for help. So, what can I do for you? You have a problem?
No, but Elena and Nikos do.
I don't understand.
We all know this trouble there's been between all this quarreling about the offer that's been made for the taverna.
Oh, that, yes, of course I know. It has caused much unhappiness, for Elena particularly. And Nikos is angered and hurt by her stubbornness.
What do you think about it all?
That Elena is probably right. At the end, the decision must be hers alone. Anyway, the taverna belongs to her.
Are you happy about the situation?
Of course not.
But wouldn't you like to see it resolved?
Yes, I would, Leandros, but it's between them. Only they can find the answer. I cannot interfere.
Well, that means they'll go on quarreling and continue to be unhappy.
Until one of them puts the feelings of the other above their own ambitions.
Or until a compromise is found.
You have something in mind?
Yes, I do. I've already talked to Elena about it, and, well, she's in favor. But she seems to think we've got to have an ally to persuade Nikos, even to get him to listen. And she's convinced that ally has to be you.
I never realized that I had any influence over Nikos.
Yes, apparently, a great deal.
So, first, I have to be persuaded. Is that it?
Yes.
Very well, Leandros. Persuade me. I think it's a wonderful idea. One that has many advantages. And one that you and Elena should consider very seriously, Nikos.
Sailing holidays.
That's it. Based on the taverna, but with the place suitably enlarged to get in enough guests to make a go of it.
That would mean a lot of rebuilding.
No. Some, but not a lot. As you can see, it would all be in the same style of architecture, like that.
And the boats?
There'd be 50 of them sailing dinghies, specially designed for these waters.
Designed by you?
Yes, that's right, but built here in Crete. That may be exciting for someone with experience, and very easy for a beginner to handle.
That sounds very good. And if you're right about the profits which you think there is to be made...
Dick, I promise you, the figures in there are very conservative. It cannot miss.
It would need a lot of money to do all this, and it's not easy to get money from the bank now.
You wouldn't have to go to a bank. I put up the capital.
You haven't?
Yes, I've got money to invest. It's not a fortune, but it's certainly enough For all that, and there's nothing I'd rather be involved in. We'd be partners, the three of us.
Oh, that's a very good offer, Nikos.
Would you like this?
Oh, yes, yes.
Well, I'll need to think over what is written here. All that you've said, also.
Well, naturally.
Perhaps you know that there's another offer on which we have yet to give an answer.
And so be it.
That must still be taken into consideration. But I will say this. I think this is a very clever idea, Leandros. Καταφέρνω να γίνει πάρα πολύ όμορφη έτσι.
Βέβαια. Κοίταξε να δεις. Οπωσδήποτε θα γίνουν αλλαγές, αλλά όχι τεράστιες αλλαγές, κατάλαβες.
Thank you for your help, for being there, your support, everything.
Oh, I did nothing. I spoke only the truth, what I truly believe.
Thanks, anyway.
Will you come in for a drink? Oh, please, Leandros. Passion, Leandros. Such longing. No Greek could have written that. It's the anguish of a more disciplined soul. And more moving, perhaps, because of that. It's the music of the North. Your music.
But it speaks to you.
Because it's universal. That is genius. And each time you hear it, it's a new revelation.
Could you live away from Crete?
I did. For more than 1 year, I was in England studying.
You're happy there?
No. Because my life was empty. There was nothing shared in it. But if there had been, yes, I could have been happy. And if there was now, I could live anywhere. Places are not important. Are they?
No.
Only people.
Only people.
Don't say you are sorry, please. I think you were going to. I wouldn't want that.
You're a very beautiful woman.
If that is how I am to you, then I'm glad. For you're a very special man.
Nothing's wrong. It's just that it's late, very late. I must go.
You do not have to leave. You know that, don't you? I don't want you to go.
Good night, Anika. Thank you.
Leandros. There's something, isn't there? Something that's a barrier between us. Is it a ghost?
Why do you say that?
Because there are times that I think I see it in your eyes, that you're haunted by something, by someone.
Anika, what if I were to tell you...
To tell me what?
Nothing. There's nothing to tell. Good night.
You're looking tired, Caterina.
I know it. I am. I don't sleep easily. I have much on my mind.
What's troubling you?
Many things. My daughter.
Annika? But she's well. You don't have to worry about her.
She is a foolish child.
A woman, Caterina. Foolish? Perhaps, yes, sometimes, but then who of us is not?
She has been spoiled by the world outside Crete. She is stubborn and headstrong.
Spoiled? No. Stubborn, headstrong. Yes, she goes her own way. She always has. But when the path that she has chosen has become difficult and she has stumbled, not once has she complained. And when she has fallen, she has picked herself up. She has great courage.
Perhaps, but she is obstinate. And her obstinacy has already once ruined her life.
You speak of her marriage, divorce?
And now?
Now?
She still doesn't take my advice. She doesn't listen. And Elena. I'm also concerned about her. From all that I hear, she still refuses to sell the taverna.
You seldom leave this house, Caterina. But is there anything which happens on Crete which does not reach your ears?
Little of importance, and nothing that concerns the family. Elena should not humiliate Nikos. She must show him more respect. He is her husband. She should follow him in all things. That is the duty of every woman. There is much of Annika in her, I fear.
No. Elena loves her aunt. She admires her, but they're not alike in any way.
In stubbornness, at least. Why does she not agree to the sale, Babis? Is the price offered not a good one?
Very good.
Then why?
I'm not sure.
I tell you, the same obstinacy. And what good comes of it? None. And no happiness either for her or for Nikos. Talk to her, Babis. Persuade her. As my friend, as her godfather, for her own good.
If I could be convinced of that. But in any case, it may not now be necessary.
Mm?
You see, you don't hear everything after all. Another offer has been made, one which pleases Elena and also Nikos, I think.
Oh, what is this offer?
A partnership. Capital to be invested in the taverna and to make it into a very profitable business.
A partnership? Who makes this offer?
A friend of mine, a good man. His name is Alan Haldane. He fought here with us in Crete during the war. We called him Leandros. You must know of him.
Yes, I know of him.
Hello, Alan. Well, I'm here. I brought you something. Oh, what a charming place. Oh, it's lovely. It really is. You know, I couldn't believe it when your telegram arrived. But it was true. And here I am. Let me look at you. Oh, you look marvelous.
You too.
Living in Crete is obviously good for you. Well, let's have a drink, eh, darling, to celebrate. I'm all butterflies, and I'm talking too much. I know it, but I can't help it. I'm happy. Happy, but just a little bit embarrassed. And this will give you a laugh. Shy. But it'll pass. A drink would be nice, though.
Yeah, sure. Sorry. Have some of this. Straight?
You've forgotten. Water. Same again.
Of course, sorry. I'll get some ice.
No, thanks. Thank you, darling. Cheers.
Cheers.
I bet you were surprised to get my letter, weren't you?
Yes, I was.
I got your address from your brother. I had to really persuade him. He wasn't at all keen to give it to me. And he could have been so right. Oh, I see you're still working on boats. I'm glad. You wouldn't be happy doing anything else. Yes, he could have been so right. I said to myself when I wrote to you, you're crazy, Lorna Matthews, you know that? Crazy. I mean, supposing he just doesn't want to know. All he'll think is that you're pushing and it'll put him right off. But I had to let you know. You see, this man who's asked me to marry him, well, he's nice, he's kind, he's considerate, and he loves me. I'm not in love with him, but he'd make a good husband. Emotional security and all that. And, well, I'm 42, for God's sake, and with two marriages on the rocks already, I'm not exactly the woman of the month choice. Could be that someone like Philip isn't going to turn up again. But with us, it was different, wasn't it? We really had something going for us, didn't we? Something special. And for four whole years, four wonderful years I'll never forget. I've stored up those years, Alan. I've lived off them like a squirrel through a long winter. You know, I can't think of a damn thing we didn't agree about. And we were good for each other, weren't we? In every way. Well, that's why when Philip asked me to marry him, I had to be sure. I had to be certain there wasn't a hope in hell of us ever getting together again. So, with my pride suitably anaesthetized with scotch, I wrote you that letter. I can tell you I regretted it the next morning when the anaesthetic had worn off. I thought, oh, what the hell have you done? I suppose you just embarrass him. Suppose he doesn't care. Suppose he laughs. But it was too late by then. The letter had gone, and all I could do was sit and wait and bite my fingernails. And then your telegram arrived. Seat booked on flight 206, the 20th. All my love, Alan. You didn't have to do that. Just a telegram saying get out here would have been enough.
Lorna, sit down. I don't think there's any easy way of saying this, but this can't go on. I didn't buy you a ticket. And I didn't send you this.
You didn't send it?
No.
And the ticket?
No.
I don't... You're joking, aren't you?
It is not a joke. It's the truth.
It can't be the truth. It can't be.
But it is.
But I don't understand. If you didn't send the telegram, if you didn't send the ticket, who did?
I don't know. But when I find out, I'll break their necks.
Who would do such a thing? Who would be so cruel?
At the moment, I've no idea.
Why?
But I can't imagine. I got your letter, but I didn't show it to anybody else. No one else could have read it.
Then it has to have been you.
But it wasn't. As I said, I got your letter. I thought about it. I was very touched. I wrote back to you only yesterday. I wished you luck and every happiness.
I see.
I'm sorry, Lorna. And I'm even sorrier about all this and angrier than you'll ever know. Look, this man who's asked you to marry him, what's his name? Philip. Did you say anything to him before you left?
No. I wanted to see you first. I wanted to be absolutely sure.
There's something that's this.
Is it? Is it? My God, no, it is. Who could have done such a thing? To make me believe. Who could be so cruel? Let me make a sort of fool of my...
Come on, I want to stop it. Stop it. Come on, come on.
Now I'm making an even bigger fool of myself.
No, you not. You know, I wouldn't have had to hurt like this for the world, believe me.
I do. It's a bastard thing to do, and that's not your style. Maybe that's why I love you.
Sorry. I had no idea. Forgive me.
Annika! Annika!
Who is she?
Her name's Annika Zafiri.
And she's important to you?
She's a friend. It's, well, it's just that I wouldn't want her to think... Doesn't matter, I suppose.
Doesn't it? Where will she go now?
Home, I expect.
Well, then follow her. Explain, tell her why.
No, perhaps it's better this way.
You want her to misunderstand?
It's a way out.
And that's what you're looking for, a way out?
It's a situation that I can do nothing about.
Complications?
One or two.
Is she married?
Worse than that, but, well, that's my problem. Or rather, it was.
Was?
Well, I would say so, wouldn't you? Anyway, Lorna, what about you? What are you going to do?
Go back to England, to Philip. He wants us to get married next month, just a quiet... Is there a flight out of here tonight?
I don't know. I expect so. Come, that's ridiculous. We just arrived and us travelling for one day.
Oh, tomorrow, then.
Why don't you stay on for a bit and have a holiday?
No, I don't think that would be a good idea. Neither do you, really. Tomorrow.
Okay, I'll ring a hotel.
Alan. Not a hotel.
Sorry. I didn't mean to wake you.
I wasn't asleep. I've been watching you. You've been standing there for almost an hour.
That long? Seemed like only a few minutes. I've got something on my mind.
Annika?
me about it.
There's nothing that anyone can do.
Might help.
Well, you know that I was here in Crete during the war with the partisans.
Yes, I know.
Well, there was a girl. She was also with the partisans. Her name was Melina. And we were very, very much in love. And in 1944, I was sent back to England. And, well, one thing I wanted, I was going to do, was come back here and marry her. So I wrote when I got back, but I got no reply. I wrote a second time, still no reply. When she didn't answer my third letter, I thought, well, that she must have changed her mind and found someone else.
And had she?
Yes, but only because she needed to, because she had to. You see, when I left, Melina discovered that she was pregnant. I only found out about this a few weeks ago when I came back here. Apparently, she didn't receive any of the letters I read. And, well, she assumed that I'd forgotten her, abandoned her. So she married someone else just to protect the child.
And now you've seen her again?
No, no. She died 4 years ago. And the man she married, he was killed on the mainland fighting in 1949. But I have met my daughter. Her name's Elena. She and her husband run a taverna here in Alunda.
Does she know who you are?
No. No, and she mustn't ever. There's only one person that knows. There's a good friend of mine in Heraklion who told me this whole story. And, of course, there are you.
Do you see her quite often?
Yep.
Isn't that difficult for you?
Very. But she has problems and she needs some help, and I'm going to make sure she gets it.
Yes. But what has all this to do with Annika?
Annika? I first met her 2 days after I came back here. That was before I knew all this story about Melina. And meeting her was like coming face to face with someone that you know you've always been looking for.
Yes, I know that feeling.
Sorry.
But, I don't understand. So you met Annika. Where's the problem? You don't want to tell her about your daughter, is that it?
No, the problem is that Annika is Melina's sister, and my daughter is her niece.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Came as quite a shock to me, too. Only I found out too late.
And you can't tell her?
Well, if I did, I'd lose her for sure, I know that. And it would be, that would hurt her too much. I mean, I was her sister's lover. How could I ever convince her that I didn't abandon Melina? She'd hate me for that alone.
That's better she thinks there's someone else.
Well, isn't it? There is no way that I can tell her the truth. I just couldn't. It'd be too cruel.
May I come in?
Are you alone?
Yes. I have to talk to you.
I cannot imagine what we have to talk about.
Yesterday, when you found Alan and I together...
That's hardly any of my business, is it?
Yes, it is, because you made a mistake. A big one.
Did I?
Look, Alan and I had an affair. It lasted a long time. It ended 3 years ago. We were lovers. Were. Past tense.
Really? And the present indicative?
Alan was kissing me because I was upset. Yes, we went to bed together.
I'm sorry, I don't understand. Are you here to boast or to confess? Either way, you have come to the wrong place. I'm not in the market for spies, nor am I a priest. And it's none of my concern.
Oh, yes, it is. Because Alan's in love with you.
Neither to boast nor to confess. You are a messenger. Is that it?
He doesn't know I'm here. He's in love with you. I thought it might be important for you to know that.
If it was of any interest to me, you must forgive me if I doubt it, in view of what you have told me.
Look, Alan took me to bed last night because he was saying goodbye in the way that he knew I wanted him to say it. Because he's that kind of person, that's all.
Goodbye?
Yes, I'm leaving today. I only came here in the first place because of a very cruel joke someone played.
Lorna? Lorna? Lorna?
I'm sorry, forgive me. I understand now, but the telegram, the ticket. Who? Why?
Alan swears he'll find out. And if he does, God help whoever did it. Well, that's all I wanted to say. Must be going or I'll miss my plane. Alan will be wondering where I am. He's driving me to the airport.
You have to love him very much to do this for him.
You're damn right I do.
What's your name?
Lorna.
You have a great heart, Lorna, and much courage. I wish we were friends.
No way. You've got what I want.
He told you this? That he loves me?
Yes. And I only came here to confirm it, just in case you were in any doubt.
There have been times when I have thought it.
Well, you were right. And if you love him, hold on to that thought. No matter what cause he gives you to question it. No matter what happens. Be good to him. He's a fine man. Someone worth holding on to. I wish to God I'd been able to.
Hey, where on earth have you been? Must be on the way to the airport by now.
I have one or two things to do.
Right, well, I'll put your bag in the car. You ready?
Well, in case there isn't time later, take care of yourself, Alan. Be happy.
And you?
All things considered, I think I stand the better chance.
Checked. It wasn't difficult. I went to every travel agent in Heraklio. It has been confirmed to me. You bought the ticket. So it was you who sent the telegram.
It was for your own good.
No, that's not true. It wasn't done from any concern for me. You did it because you're a jealous and spiteful man. I thought you were my friend. I was wrong. It's true that you have always managed the refinery well for me. I shall miss you for that, at least. Don't go back there. Whatever money is due to you, I will see you receive it.
This Leandros, he's the wrong man for you.
That must be my decision, one way or the other. It was never your right to make it. And I shall give you this advice. Light a candle against Leandros ever find out that it was you who did that to him.
I'm not afraid of him. Let him come looking for me. Better he should light candles and pray. No matter what he was or what he did in Crete in the past. Remember, he's still a foreigner and I have many friends. It could be that if I sneeze, he catches cold. And that if I spit, he drowns.
So what is it that is so urgent, Mother? So dark, so secret that it would not be spoken of on the telephone.
It is a matter of honor. It concerns your sisters. Melina, may her soul be at peace. And Anika. A man has come to Crete who threatens the good name of one and the happiness of the other, who threatens us all. And you have no choice, Petros. You must go against this man. And if there is need for it, destroy him.